బిస్మిల్లాహిర్ రహ్మాన్ రహీమ్. గారు మూలాసనారూఢ మంత్రితుమణి, మమ ඉතාමත් සතුටු වෙනවා මගේ අමාත්‍යාංශ වෑශීෂ්‍ය විවාදයට ගන්නා මේ අවස්ථාවේදී අප අමාත්‍යාංශ වෙනුවෙන් වචන ස්වල්පයක් කතා කිරීමට, විශේෂයෙන්ම මේ කාරක සභා අවස්ථාවේදී එක එක් අමාත්‍යාංශවල ප්‍රගතිය පිළිබඳව අමාත්‍යාංශයට අමාත්‍යාංශයේ ඉදිරි වැඩපිළිවෙල පිළිබඳව විස්තරාත්මක කතා කිරීමට සිදු වුණත් අපට මේ සීමිත කාල සීමාවත් තුළ හැම දෙයක් පිළිබඳව අපි කතා කිරීමට බැරිකමක් ඇති වීම ගැනම කනගාටු වෙමින් ඔබතුමාගෙන් ඉල්ලීමක් කරනවා. මේ අපි මගේ කතාවේ මේක එකතු කරන්න බැරි කොටස් හැන්සාඩ් වාර්තාවට එකතු කරන්ටයි කියලා. මොකද අපිට ආපු විවේචන පිළිබඳව මට පිළිතුරු දෙන්න සිදුවෙන බැවින් විශේෂයෙන්ම ඔබතුමන්ගේ පක්ෂීය නායකතුමා අනුර කුමාර දිසානායක මැතිතුමන් ප්‍රහාරාත්මක
ඕඩර් ප්ලීස් දරු කතානායකතුමා මූලාසනට.
Go ahead, Honorable Minister.
Honorable Speaker, I was making a request to the member presiding before you came on to the chair, a very humble request that you be pleased to permit us to include the speech that have been prepared on behalf of the ministry to be included in the Hansard, since I have got to take much of the time that is allocated to answer certain criticisms that have been leveled against us. Honorable Speaker, you are quite aware, particularly relating to certain projects that we are implementing in your own district. Garu Kathanayakathumani, visheshayenma Gampaha Attanagalla Vyaputiya Pilibandava Praharathmaka Vivechana Karapu Ape Anura Kumara Disanayaka Mathumanta Mama පිළිතුරක් දීම මගේ වගකීමයි. විශේෂයෙන්ම මේ ව්‍යාපෘතිය ජනගහන 300,000කට පළවෙනි අදියරනුත් දෙවැනි අදියරේ තවත් ලක්ෂයක ප්‍රමාණ ජනගහනයටත් පානීය ජලය ලබා දීමට අපි යෝජනා කරන වැඩපිළිවෙලක් මේකින් ග්‍රාම නිලධාරී වසම් 449ක් ආවරණය වෙන පරිදි කරන රටේ අපි දියත් කරන විශාලතම වැඩපිළිවෙලක් හැටියට නැත්නම් ව්‍යාපෘතියක් හැටියට මේක හැඳින්විය හැකි. මේ ඒ විතරක් නෙවෙයි 3.5 MCM ධාරිතාවක් ඇති ස්ටෝරේජ් එකක් ඇති රිසර්වයර් එකක් බස්නාගොඩ සෑදීමටත් අපි මේක අදහස් කළා. තමයි මේ සෑදීම සඳහා අපේ ජල සම්පාදන මණ්ඩලයත් අපේ දායකත්වය ලබා දී තන අපිටත් මිලියන 600ක් මේකෙන් ලැබෙන්න නියමිතයි. අපි මේ ව්‍යාපෘතියේ පටන් මේ ව්‍යාපෘතියේ ප්‍රතිසම්පාදන ක්‍රියාවලිය අපි මේ ආණ්ඩුව බාර ගැනීමට කලින් ලබා දීලා ඉන් පසුව වැඩ පටන් අරන් තිබුණු අවධියක තමයි අපට මේක බාර ගන්න සිදු වුණේ. එබැවින් ඒක ඒ පිළිබඳව තිබුණු විවේචන සැලකිල්ලට අරගෙන ඒ සඳහා අපි වෙනම කමිටුවක් පත් කරලා ඒ අධ්‍යයනය කරලා ඒ නැවත ඒ ඒ පිළිබඳව තිබුණු ඒ එන්ජිනේර් එස්ටිමේට් වඩා 118.5ක වැඩිවීමක් තිබුණු බැවින් ඒක අඩු කරගැනීම සඳහා අපි කටයුතු කළා කියන එක මම මතක කළ යුතුයි. ඉතින් මේ පිළිබඳව තවත් විස්තර කීපයක් අපි අනුර කුමාර දිසානායක මැතිතුමාට ලබා දෙන්න මම අදහස් කරනවා. ඒ වගේම විශේෂයෙන්ම අපේ ණයබරතාවයේ පිළිබඳව ජාතික ජල සම්පාදන ජලපවාහන මණ්ඩලය අපේ නගරාසන්න ප්‍රදේශවල තියෙන අපේ ව්‍යාපෘති වලට 50%ක ඒ ණය පියවීමේ වගකීම අපි දරන අතර ඒකෙන් ඉතිරි කොටස භාණ්ඩාගාරයේ පියවීම සඳහා බාර අරන් තිබෙනවා. මේ පිළිබඳව අපි ඇමති මණ්ඩල සංදේශයක් කරහා ඒ එකඟත්වයට එළඹී තිබෙනවා. ඒ වගේම ගම්බද ප්‍රදේශවල 25%ක් අපි දරන අතර 75%ක් භාණ්ඩාගාරය ගෙවීමට එකඟ වෙලා තිබෙනවා. ඒත් සමගම වකුගඩු රෝගය පැතිරී ගිය ප්‍රදේශවල අපි ක්‍රියාත්මක කරන ව්‍යාපෘති වලට 100%ක්ම භාණ්ඩාගාරයේ ආපසු ගෙවීමට එකඟ වෙලා තියෙන බවත් මම කිව යුතුයි. එබැවින් මේ ණයබරතාවයේ පිළිබඳව අපි දැරීමට තියෙන බර අඩු කිරීමට අපට භාණ්ඩාගාරයත් ඒ වගේම මුදල් අමාත්‍යාංශයත් එකඟත්වය පළ කිරීම පිළිබඳව මාගේ ස්තුතිය මුදින් පුද කර සිටිනවා. එබැවින් මේ නමුත් ඊට වඩා අපිට අපේ ගාස්තු සංශෝධනය පිළිබඳව විශේෂයෙන්ම මේ පානීය ජලය පිළිබඳව දැන් අවුරුදු 4කට වැඩිය අපට මිල සංශෝධනයක් නොකිරීම උඩ විශාල ගැටලු රාශියකට අපි මුහුණ පාන්න සිදු වුණත් අපි රජයේ තීරණයක් මත ඒක නැවත සංශෝධනයට ලක් කිරීම අපි පමා කරලා තියෙන පිළිබඳවත් අපි කියා සිටිය යුතුයි. Then, Honorable Speaker, then on the question of treasury guarantees which are given for local loans and on sovereign guarantees which are given for foreign loans, all these loans are taken only after obtaining treasury or sovereign guarantees, which has been the practice as far as we are concerned. I must also say here that we have, during the past few years, not been allocated any specific sum for investment in the drinking water sector through consolidated fund, and we have been asked to borrow directly, and that has caused severe stress on our financial status. In order to overcome that, we are now looking at other means of engaging with the private sector, particularly through PPP schemes. One of the main PPP projects that is to be implemented is presently going through the tender procedure. It will soon be finalized. We will, while looking at it, we will also be, because that is a project called Valuevita project, which will supply water to the Colombo city. Together with that, we are looking at a variety of other options as well. Together with that, I need to also deal with a few other questions that have been raised, and particularly on the question of HDPE pipes, that again Andrakumar Dissanayake raised this issue. There are, I must say that there is only one HDPE pipe supplier in Sri Lanka, and he has got this SLS standard. It is in fact a matter regarding which I too intervened and tried to address the issue, spoke to the project director, and this is a since we have local suppliers, we since there is only one local supplier with these standards, the argument is that they must, in order to invite competition, that we have to call for international tenders. But this is a policy issue. I am sure we must address this issue and support local industry. And since there is a local industry already producing these pipes, it would certainly be an issue regarding which a policy decision must be taken, support the local industries, and this is a matter regarding which I too agree with the Honourable Member who raised this issue. Then on several other issues too, we have to give our response. And then there is, he raised another very serious allegation pertaining to the Polonnaruwa East Water Supply Project. This scheme, I must say, is covering an area which has been very seriously affected by chronic kidney disease. And in this current, Cabinet has taken a policy decision. Wherever there is a chronic kidney disease area, that the Treasury will bear the entire responsibility to pay back the loan. Based on that, though this loan is a quite a large amount, we must say that this loan is being procured through the Chinese Exim Bank on their concessionary loan scheme with the lower interest levy, and therefore there is only a single bidder whose bid is to be negotiated, we have put in some strict conditions that the contractor will not be paid any price escalation, and that the risk of foreign currency fluctuations should be borne by the contractor. Together with that, a shorter implementation period will be available, since the procurement has to be completed within 2019. There was a cabinet decision to complete all these projects in the CKD areas within 2019. Then the Chinese Exim Bank soft loan package is what is being procured for this purpose, and this loan will be serviced entirely by the Treasury, and there is no burden on the National Water Supply and Drainage Board. Then we are also compelled to look into this issue, particularly since we have to somehow reach 60% target by 2020, and we also have a much bigger role to play in reaching the 2030 Sustainable Development Goals, which have been identified by the United Nations. Then, then about the new bank loan that we had taken through a joint cabinet paper in order to pay back some of our commitments. This loan had been arranged through the Treasury due to the non-availability of Government of Sri Lanka counterpart funds for a variety of loans that were taken. And these counterpart funds had to be met, and then we had to pay other levies such as VAT and other taxes that has to be paid to the contractor. And therefore, the Treasury was advising us to all these ministries, three other ministries together with ours, had to go for an overdraft from the commercial banks, and that too has to be negotiated by the External Resources Department, and then we will be able to settle those commitments. In the meantime, Treasury has fully undertaken to repay that overdraft. Therefore, that again is not going to be a further burden on the Water Supply and Drainage Board's stressed finances, and that should be mentioned here. Then there was also a question raised about the public-private partnership relating to desalination project, and there was a unsolicited desalination project which had been awarded to one of these parties that was mentioned by the Honourable Andhra Kumar Dissanayake. Here, I must say that it has not been finalised yet. Only a proposal was submitted by a private party on the request of Northern Provincial Council, and that issue is still pending. And again, issue relating to the salaries of the workers of the National Water Supply and Drainage Board, it is true that we had agreed to revise it every 3 years. A committee has been appointed with the additional general manager in charge, and this committee will study and provide the recommendations, and I also expect the trade unions to agree to a collective agreement before we are able to give them another revised salary scheme. Then also, Honourable Charles had raised certain issues relating to the water projects in Mena area, Udaipuram, Pesale and Samad area, which he had referred to. These areas are included under the Asian Development Bank Dry Zone project, and these areas are included, and presently they are under procurement process. Then Sannar, Ichilambattu and Kayanagar areas. Yes, Mr. Speaker. An 100 million estimate had been made to these for that particular project, and we are waiting for some funding to be made available. Then I must also add here a few words in Tamil, Honourable Speaker. Nangal engode amaichu noodaga nagara thittamidal pirivu என்பது குறிப்பாக கல்முனை சாய்ந்தமருது பிரதேசங்களை உள்ளடக்கி சம்மாந்துறை நகரத்தையும் உள்ளடக்கியதாக பாரிய ஒரு புதிய நகர அபிவிருத்தி திட்டம் ஒன்றுக்கான ஒதுக்கீடு இந்த இம்முறை இந்த வரவு செலவு திட்டத்திலே எங்களுக்கு தரப்பட்டிருக்கிறது. அதனூடாக நாங்கள் ஏற்கனவே தயாரித்திருக்கிற மாஸ்டர் பிளானின் அடிப்படையிலே அந்த ரெண்டு நகரங்களும் கல்முனை சம்மாந்துறை உட்பட ஒரு பாரிய அபிவிருத்தி திட்டம் ஒன்றை நாங்கள் அமல்படுத்த இருக்கிறோம். அதே போல் ஹெதோய அபிவிருத்தி திட்டத்தையும் நிச்சயமாக அடுத்த வருடம் ஆரம்பிப்பதற்கான ஏற்பாடுகள் நடந்து கொண்டிருக்கின்றன. முக்கியமாக பொத்துவில் பிரதேசத்துக்கு அவசியமான குடிநீரையும் விவசாயத்துக்கான நீரையும் பெற்றுக்கொள்வதற்காக விவசாய அமைச்சும் அதாவது நீர்ப்பாசன அமைச்சும் நாங்களும் இணைந்து இந்த செயல் திட்டத்தை அமுல்படுத்துவதற்காக நடவடிக்கைகள் எடுக்கப்பட்டிருக்கு. இதற்கென்று விசேடமான அமைச்சரவை பத்திரத்தின் மூலம் அனுமதியும் கிடைத்திருக்கிறது என்று சொல்லிக்கொள்வதோடு வாழைச்சேனைக்கான அந்த நீர்வளங்கள் திட்டமும் அமுல்படுத்தப்பட இருக்கிறது என்பதையும் நாங்கள் குறிப்பிட்டாக வேண்டும். இவ்வகையம கத்தநாயக துமணி அப்பி ஜலசம்பாதன கிரம கீப்பி அப்பிலிபந்த கட்டத்துக்கு இருக்கணும். ஏ பிலிபந்த விஸ்தராத்மக தீனமகே கதாவே கொட்டச கருணாகர மே ஹன்சாட் வார்த்தாவை அத்திருத்தமின்
இல்லமின்
கதாவ சமாப்த கரணும்.
கௌரவ ஆரந்திக மெத்துமணி பேஹஜிலி கிரீமாத்த
நே அமெத்துமா மே கதாவக் நிசா மட்டும் ஒபத்துமாக இக்க பேஹஜிலி கிரீமாக திஸ் இஸ் அபவுட் திஸ் பெல்ஜியம் ப்ரொஜெக்ட் தேர் இஸ் திஸ் வெண்ணப்பூ நாத்தண்டியன் Dangote Belgium project, the estimate amount was 20,000 million US dollars. Now it has reduced up to 11,000 million US dollars. Now what they are asking is another 450 million funds for this till you finish this Belgium project. I just want to know the status of this Belgium project of my area.
To a project we had asked for some funding from Belgium. In fact, the Honourable Speaker knows Belgium funding is at a very concessional rate.
Yeah.
So, but then the loan cycle takes quite some time to negotiate, and we will certainly once that, of course, the counterpart funding issue we can sort out, but the moment funding option is sorted out through the External Resources Department. Okay.
Thank you very much, Honourable Minister.